Hello there. I've just been enjoying this article on the Enterprise DNA website, and it's really good. It's discussing how we can use conditional formatting in calculation groups. And I wanted to use that technique to achieve something slightly different. And that thing that I want to achieve is what you can see on my screen now. It's basically allowing us to show every other column a different color. I think it just looks tidy, and it's something that people have requested quite often, which I understand. It's something that's very achievable in Excel, and for me should be easier in Power BI. But this is how we can do it. It's great. So as with all of my favorite techniques, you don't need a lot of DAX and you need a little bit of M in Power Query. Bring those two things together and it works pretty wonderfully. So let's take a look and see how it goes. We're going to start with the Power Query part. And then we're going to jump back into Power BI, and then we'll finish it off with a bit of DAX. So this is the Power Query part. And what we're going to do in Power Query is create a custom column that gives every other column the same value. So what am I talking about? Well, in our date table, we can quite easily create age. Yeah, and this is what I've done in this date table. I do that actually in all my date tables because it's a really good slicer. And I think I have a video about that, which I'll also link up here. So first of all, if you don't know how to create age, very simple. You go to date, you go to add column, and you go from date, and you just click on age. And what that does is it gives you a value for every single day. So one is yesterday, two days ago, 3 days ago, etc. And then you just change that to a whole number. Just like that. But I already have age, so I'm just gonna get rid of that. Like that. So you need age. Once you created your age column, you're then gonna create a second column. It's nice and straightforward, and it sounds like a lot maybe, but it's not. It's really basic, and I think what it achieves is very much worth it. So I'm now gonna create a custom column. And this custom column is going to give me one of two potential values, which is odd or even. One, of course, is odd, two is even, and that kind of, you know, follows through. So I'm going to say if number is odd, just like that, and then I'm going to correct the horrible M IntelliSense, number is odd, age. Then give me odd, else even. So that's it. If number is odd, then give me the word odd. If it's not, then give me the word even, just to make it really clear as to what's happening. And I'm going to call this odd or even, which might be a terrible column name. But again, this is just for the clarity of what we're doing. And now we have this column. Odd or even. And you can see odd, even, odd, even, odd, even. So maybe now it's starting to be clear as how we're going to define these colors in the columns. So let's keep going. But that's it. I mean, for the Power Query side, we're done. I'll show you a second technique in a little bit in case you're not using a date table or dates in your columns, but it's very similar. So we can now load this and go back to Power BI. So we're now in Power BI, and the first thing I'm going to do, of course, is I'm going to remove my conditional formatting so we can do this stage together. So quickly switch that off. And now we're back to very standard, no conditional formatting on this visualization. So what we do need to do now is create a DAX measure. And it's, as all of my solutions, which I enjoy, it has a very, very basic DAX. So I'm going to copy and paste it, and then we'll just go through it. So this measure, I'm going to call even format. Call it whatever you want. So what's it doing? We're saying if the selected value of the column that we've just created, our column was called odd or even. We just created that in the date table, right? So if the selected value of odd or even is odd, so if selected value odd or even in odd, so if it is odd, is what we're saying, then return this measure. We could make it really one of many measures. What's important is that the measure has a value on that day. If it doesn't, then blank. Yeah? So if the selected value of the column that we just created, the odd or even, is odd, then give me the value of visit rank. If it's not odd, then just give me blank. That's it. Nice and straightforward. I'm going to use that measure for our conditional formatting. So, first of all, we're going to go down to our conditional formatting. And I'm going to go switch it on. And it gives you your standard Power BI conditional formatting. We go to advanced controls, and then we do what we do. Format style from gradient to rules. What field should we base this on? Well, we're going to base it on the field that we just created, which was called even format. I have two versions because I was using one before. So this part is slightly different because now actually you want it to cover everything. If it's greater or equal to the lowest value, or if it's less than or equal to zero, if it's greater than zero, and it's greater or less than or equal to the maximum value. So basically, we're going to say if it's any number. If it's any number, if it's from the lowest to the highest, then give me this color. And then actually, I'll switch on values and totals. And that's it. Now we select OK. And there we have it. Through that, those two simple steps, this tiny bit of DAX and this tiny bit of M, together we have columns that are conditionally formatted to show every other value. It's a different color. Nice and straightforward. So that's it, really. That's the technique. I will show you a different way in case, because obviously in that situation, we were using a date value. Now, a date is probably slightly easier, but only slightly easier, because you're going to do the same thing if you're not using a date, but you're simply going to use a index. So I'll hop to a different report and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So in this example, I want to use a slightly different value in my columns. So instead of using a date, I'm using the name of a football club. So this is just to show how it can be done if you don't have a date. It's very, very similar, but just to show you how it's done. So basically, we're going to do exactly the same technique, but slightly differently. So let's go to Power Query, as we did before, and do that section. We are going to now create what we can use for our odd and even logic. Really straightforward. All we're going to do, we are going to add an index number. We're going to go from 1, could go from 0, but I'll go from 1. So now we have our index, and from this point, it's probably clear what we're going to do now. We're going to do exactly what we did before. We're going to use that index, and we're going to create a custom column, and that's going to tell us if it's odd or an even. Nice. So, same as before, if number is odd, same as before, correct horrific IntelliSense, index, then say odd, else tell me even, and I've somehow managed to miss out two letters there, else even. So if the number is odd, then say odd. If not, say even. Give it a name. Cool. So now we have the column that we need, which is odd or even. We're going to load that back into Power BI, and then we're going to go. So now that's loaded. I want to take the measure we had before, same measure, and just adapt it to this particular report and this data. So I am going to create a measure. And we're simply going to reference the column that we just created. And then we'll reference, of course, a different measure. So if selected value odd or even, if it's odd, then give me a value, and let's use total points by game week. That was blank. So again, very simple measure. If the selected value of odd or even is odd, then give us the measure total points by game week. If not, give me blank. So very straightforward. And the conditional formatting is going to be applied in exactly the same way. I'm going to go here to our conditional formatting, as we did before, switch it on, advanced controls. And then you'll see it hasn't done it every other, it's done it that way. Why? Because what we need to do is we need to go to our table that we're looking at, sort the team abbreviation by index. And it's done. And if you don't like the way it started off, of course, if you want to say, okay, I want the first column to not be dark, rather light, then of course, what you can do is just go back to the measure that you've created, even format, and just switch it around. Instead of saying odd, say even, and now it's probably how I'd prefer it. That's it. This is the technique. So pretty easy to go through with. As I say, that really simple little bit of DAX, courtesy of our friends at Enterprise DNA, and a little bit of M, you get this really nice result, which is otherwise, I don't know how you do that otherwise, actually. If you do know how you do it without doing what I've just done, please let me know. But I think this is quite a nice way. I understand it's one of those things that should be easier in Power BI, but unfortunately it is not. I just realized I've forgotten to switch on the totals. So in the conditional formatting, if you want, you can do on the values and totals. You can't do on the column headers. I understand that's still frustrating, but I think it looks quite cool. Hope you liked the video. Hope it helped and you learned something. Comments below. Tell me how you feel about it. And if you enjoyed the video, as ever, it would be fantastic if you could just subscribe to my channel and, of course, like the video. Take care and goodbye.